concepts that might offend sensitive viewers. Parental guidance is advised.
This is an SABC News presentation.
Siphelile isikhathi sokuba mvikeli womphakathi ku-advocate Thuli Madonsela. Abaningi bayawubuka hle umsebenzi wakhe. Kodwa lizoba njani ofisi ngemva kokuphuma kwakhe? Indaba elindelwe ngamehlo abovu. UThuli Madonsela ubalwa nabo saziwako. Udume kangangokuthi wonke umuntu ufuna ukuthatha isithombe naye.
The reason why maybe Mhlambi we know much about her is because of the controversy that is going on or that went on when she was still in office. Not her, but izinto bezenza with the Zuma and stuff.
I think to some degree media has elevated this office to very high levels.
Kodwa akusuye wonke umuntu othabileko zinqundo zakhe.
She found against me without having spoken to me.
Nakukhulunywa ngaye iParliament lesike malijame ngenyawo.
Is he willing to accept the comments? Does he agree with them? Is he in fact willing to withdraw them?
He said, and he's not denying it, that Thuli had handlers, and that makes her a spy.
There is nowhere in the newspaper, in the Star, where there's a mention of the public protector of being a central intelligence spy.
Kodwa ifike ekugcineni indlela. Siphelile isikhathi sakhe. Abaliwe namalanga.
Can she not serve another term?
I-ofisi lomvikeli womphakathi lisuka kude ekuthomeni kombuso wedemokhrasi ngaphasi kobaba uNelson Mandela. U-advocate Selby Phaqwa waba yi-public protector yokuthoma, aqale ukusetshenziswa kumbi kwamandla minyango kahulumende. Ngabaningi bengekhe icabangeke into enjalo ngaphasi kukaMandela.
Nokuba nenkokheli efana noNelson Mandela obubona yona into kokubana ayichaphazeleki kakhulu kwingxwabangxwaba norhwaphilizo, loo nto ibingadala uba uthandabuze uba kwenzekani. Nobunzulu bobuqhetseba ne-corruption bebungekabikho nzulu ngolu hlobo silubonayo ngoku.
Kodwa ngaphasi kukaDr. Nkosazana Dlamini Zuma emnyangweni wezamaphilo, kwavela elinye lamahlazo wokuthoma lokusetshenziswa butshilweni kwemali ejimeni lokulwisana ne-HIV AIDS. Kuthiwa imali engangemali eyavele yaphoselwa nje emidlalweni odumileko weSarafina 2 kambongeni Ngema. Nokwakuthiwa uzokufundisa ilutsha nge-HIV AIDS.
Education first, sex later, work last.
Ngelo xesha sisanda ukukhululeka, abantu abaninzi bebesazi into yokuba asinawo amava okufunda ngezinto zoburhulumente. Ngoko ke bebeye bamxolele lula umntu xa kuthe kwenzeka impazamo ezifana nezo zooSarafina nemali ezachithwa apho.
Azange baxoleke abanikeli ngemali abafana ne-European Union, nokwagcina ngokuthi umvukeli womphakathi aphenye ngendaba yeSarafina 2. UDr. Olive Chisano, obeka mlawuli kezamaphilo, nguye wabeqalene nemibuzo ebudisi. ingakwathoma lapho ke ukusetshenziswa kwegama elithi pay back the money.
The money that was apparently misappropriated to Mbongeni Ngeman, will he be required to pay this back?
He is required to pay back the money. He has paid 441,000 out of approximately 952,000.
Kwalandela isifunda seMpumalanga nalapho usomkhandlu wezemali uJacques Mudipane athinde kakhona ehlazweni lokusayinela ikampani yangaphandle isithembiso semali enkulu emzameni wokubuthelelela imali iMpumalanga Parks Board. Nalapho waphika walala ngendaba.
People of Mpumalanga and people of South Africa, I did not have even a single meeting with the premier where the promissory notes were discussed. Not even a single meeting with him. And you can go back to him and ask him that question. His answer to that question will be, I never had a meeting with Mudipane where promissory notes were discussed.
Beganga khuluma iqiniso Mudipane. Wagcina avumile ukuthi kwenzile lokho ngemva kwephenyo. Kodwa owathusa isitshaba ngundunankulu wesifunda seMpumalanga uNdaweni Mashangu. Owathi kulungile abosopolitiki abanjengoMudipane bakhulume amanga.
I've heard many people denying, not only politicians, many people denying certain things and admitting later on. And I've heard politicians doing that. I don't know, it depends on any individual whether you want to take it as the most serious thing. I've heard, for instance, in America, the president of the country denying certain things before and admitting them thereafter.
Abanye ke bathi akaqothwe uMahlangu ofunga aziphikise. Umvikeli womphakathi kwathiwa akaphenye nalapho.
I have found that it is unbecoming of a member of the executive council to make a statement such as the one that was made by Premier Mahlangu, and also that the statement was inconsistent with the office that he occupies, namely that of Premier and head of the Mpumalanga provincial government.
And so what have been your recommendations?
Well, I have recommended that the matter be taken up by the legislature.
Akunalitho elikhumbulekako elenzekako kuMahlangu. Abaningi bavusa inkulumo zokuthi i-ofisi likaBhaqwa linja enganamazinyo.
Awubashiso ukungazi lapho, ngoba ngingakubeka ngigomele ukuthi kukho konke embikweni yethu. Eloko wathi abathi phecelezi ama-recommendations esawenza, 95% wawo u-government uyawenza. Ngamanye amazwi, lokho esikushoyo ukuthi akuqondiswa kuyaqondiswa. So umuntu othe asinamazinyo, amazinyo okwenzani?
U-advocate Lawrence Moshwana walandela lapho kuthiwa izinto besevele bezisiya ngokonakala.
Perhaps it is Moshwana who came at the time when things were changing, who ought to have taken some of the matters up high. But I don't think it is in his personality, never mind any political pressure that might be there, because it's also a matter of a personal character.
Bekhala kunokuphikisana ngokusebenza kwakhe nengichema eziphikisako. Yena wathimelela ngokuthi inkulumo zabo ziyinto engekho.
That statement, it's firstly not supported or substantiated by facts and evidence before us, and I can call it a sweeping statement.
Kodwa izazi nabanye abasopolitiki abafana no Julius Malema bathi bekangayazi into ayenzako.
Mushwana was just a lost case, and I don't think even if he knew, he lacked the political will and courage to act on wrongdoing.
Kusekufikeni kukaThuli Madonsela, lapho kwathi ngisho nabosopolitiki abafana noJulius Malema bafike bawuza umoya.
Yet somehow, living small became the norm. until we remember how great living big really is. At Makro, we're still big on being big. Big on convenience, experience, range, and savings. Big on the moments that matter. Rediscover how beautiful it is to be big on life.
Another round?
Julius Malema bekaphuma angena ekhotho ephakamileko ye-Northern Gauteng ngokuphathelene nokusetshenziswa kumbi kwemali emnyangweni wezokuthutha eLimpopo. Lokhu kweza ngemva kwephenyo lomvikeli womphakathi uThuli Madonsela.
She found against me without having spoken to me. But I can't have any bitterness against her. She's a human being. She is an institution. Mistakes are made by people.
Kodwa i-ofisi lomvikeli womphakathi uThuli Madonsela liyakuphika-ke ukuthi kwenziwa iphenyo ngaphandle kwakhe. UMadonsela uthi iphenyo belinqophene nomnyango wezokuthutha eLimpopo nokungiwa owanikela ithenda ekampanini On Point ebeyinobuhlobo noJulius Malema.
Because that which she said the Hawks and NPA and everyone else must get into this and investigate, I was investigated. They couldn't charge me and convict me successfully. The trust was sent to the master to investigate. The master investigated. They couldn't find anything wrong with the trust.
Noma kunjalo, uMalema sele aphenduka umsekeli omkhulu ka-advocate Thuli Madonsela emsebenzini wakhe.
The question is, will those accusations stand the test of time? I have nothing against her. I actually support her and I appreciate the good work she has done.
Usabethelwa ihlombe nanje uMadonsela ngokuthi angakhethi ubuso lokhena kaphenya ngobukhohlakali.
Personally, I'm thankful for the service that she has done for the country, because I personally think that she has been brave and she has somehow unscrewed things that no one else or probably few people would have done.
Well, I think she's done wonderful work in the recent years, and she's done a great deal in restoring confidence in the system and ensuring a sense of accountability in a sense.
I do believe that Thuli Madonsela, she's done her an excellent job in her office. I think that as a student and as a South African citizen, 110% she has really protected us, and I do feel that she is an advocate for the people.
Isiqundo sika advocate Thuli Madonsela embangweni wokusetshenziswa kwemali ngokuhluleleko nakwakhiwa umuzi kamongameli Jacob Zuma enkandla yindaba edose amehlo wabambikini indaba ngisho nangaphesheya kwelwandle.
I think to some degree media has elevated this office to very high levels, but I don't necessarily think we should blame the media in so doing. The story of Nkandla alone was glamorous. Any public protector playing in that space, because it had to be subjected to parliament, it was creating a precedent that you have never had before. And the person who had to take action was the very person subjected to the same investigation, to take action against his ministers. So it was sometimes a sheer coincidence that the presidency itself was at the center of this. And therefore the ruling political party inevitably was drawn into this. The opposition parties were drawn into this. And this was then defined as an iconic feature of what was wrong
with government at this moment.
Any offense and hurt.
Akusiyo wonke umuntu okarekileko ngalokho. Isikele likangqongqotsho wezokuphepha uEbimaphathwe ukhe wambiza ngosetshenziswa ngezobuhloli iCIA eAmerica uMadonsela. Waphika ke nokho iParliament nayimbuzako.
There is nowhere in the newspaper in the Star where there's a mention of the public protector of being a central intelligence spy.
Is he willing to accept the comments? Does he agree with them? Is he in fact willing to withdraw them?
He said, and he's not denying it, that Thuli had handlers. And that makes her a spy.
Deputy Speaker, I refuse to withdraw my remark that the Deputy Minister of Defense is an idiot.
Inkulumo ezinje, nangezinganasisekelo, kanti zivela aphi?
Because they can't falter you. So they just start throwing insult at you. And then they start labeling you and all that. Because dogs don't bark at a stationed car. So if you start complaining, it means you're a crybaby. Once you start doing something, names are going to be called on you. And I think she understands that. She never got sidetracked. See, she continued to do her work. Because there's nothing tangible, strategically, which you can bring and say she's wrong here, there. That's why you start giving her labels, because intellectually, professionally, and otherwise, you can't falter.
Thuli Madonsela is this courageous, woman who stubbornly sticks to her facts and who believed in her cause. But of course, Thuli Madonsela at times seemed to have almost overexposed herself in the media, rebutting everything, and there I think she might have almost come very close, to raising her profile at the expense of the institution. But she has done a wonderful work.
The office of Mongameli Epitori bengakabuyi kithi nependulo ngokuthi uthini ke lakhe lokugcina njengoba uThuli Madonsela akhama nje. Gazi lizokusala linjani ofisi lomvikeli womphakathi angasekho uMadonsela?
And poverty did not deter Mpumi's success.
Being an orphan or coming from poverty or having seen what HIV and AIDS does to a person that you love takes nothing away from you. It means that you are part of a selective few who have had to face a very, very marginalized struggle.
Abuse is a lonely journey that needs compassion.
I came across as a very confident, ambitious person, but behind that mask was somebody who had serious anxiety problems, a person who had knots in their stomach continuously, a person who could be in company and would feel very lonely.
Being away from his birth country did not stop his hunger to succeed.
Boxing was the way out. Turning professional would give me an income. That was the solution to the problems I've had for so many years.
For more inspiring stories, join Bupulong every Friday at 17:30.
I have the necessary skills, the necessary experience, and the understanding of the complexities of how government functions and works to be able to take over the baton from Advocate Madonsela without compromising what she has achieved.
IParliament selele uqedile umsebenzi wokuhlungela ukukhethwa komvikeli womphakathi omutsha nolandelako.
It seems like the process is well managed, and I think all the candidates are thoroughly scrutinized, as you can see in the news. And it's needed because, as you can see, they've all got big shoes to fill, from the example set by Tuli Madonsela.
Can she not serve another term?
I'm not sure if we'll get the same character, and I don't think maybe we should look at someone with the same character, but just someone who'll be able to put the interest of the people first. Not necessarily someone who will get in the office and try to do favors for people, but just someone who will try and ensure that they are brave enough to tackle issues that otherwise no one else would have wanted to tackle. Not necessarily the same character.
Sekuyaziwa-ke ukuthi u-advocate Busisiwe Mkhwebane nguye olandelako. Nokho sekunokuthonyeka enqhemeni eziphikisako ukuthi ukhe wasebenza nezobuhloli. Abanye bathi akunandaba. Ngisho noma ngaba ngwehlangano ephikisako njengothuli Madonsela.
We never had an issue with that. We have an issue with the capacity to do the work. If you do your work, we even forget which party you come from. But once you don't do your work, then we're going to have to now look at, where is she from? Who is this one? Ah, she's an ANC member. That's it. But otherwise, we don't have a problem at all.
Kodwa i-Corruption Watch ithi, ukuba lilunga lezepolitiki kungawuphazamisa umsebenzi. Ngokubona kwabo, isikhathi sika Lawrence Mushwana e-ofisini sathikazise kakhulu ngalokho.
The thing with Lawrence Mushwana was that he did show a clear bias. He was an MP, he was part of the National Council of Provinces, and thereafter he applied and he was appointed as the public protector.
Even if you are an ANC member, you are DA, you are EFF, once elected to any office or government, including parliament, there must be a level where we say these are national interests, these are basic values, and you stop thinking in a partisan way. So many of the people who are appointed to this position, it is expected that their professional ethics and professional pride to say, I'm here because I qualify to be here, will actually prevail.
Ngaphasi kwe-NPA kwaba nesililo esikhulu amapholisa weScorpion nakafakwa ngaphasi kwe-SABC. Abanye bacabanga ukuthi angeke asasebenza ngokukhululekileko. Kukwesaba okufanako ke nge-public protector.
Andibona uba kungenzeka lula oko xa uqhathanisa iScorpions ujonge ne-public protector. Public protector iyi-Chapter 9 institution ikhuselwe ngumgaqo-seko. Kwaye ukuba kuyenzeka ukuba kubekho iinzame zokuba kupheleliswa amandla ayo, sekubonakele ukuba bangakwazi ukubalekela enkundleni, bafike khona bathi naku siba nale ngxaki. Akekho kurhulumente ozawufuna ukumane esithi uyaxolisa aphinda uqala phantsi. Bazawuzama ukuba nabo ubudlelwane, kodwa ke akusikuba ipolitiki noxinzelelo lwaya luziba khona.
Ngemva kwalokhu angeze busafana ubudlelwane hlangana kwe-ofisi yomvikeli womphakathi, ipalamende nomongameli, ngitsho noma angasekho e-ofisini uJacob Zuma.
The judiciary and some of your Chapter 9 institutions have proven to be the last line of defense, because in other places in the continent, soon after independence, they started on a path towards democratization, then you have a military coup, or you have a personal rule, or you have some dictatorship of any form. And in our case, it looks like those checks and balances and our constitution makes it very difficult for any party, for any leader to override it.
The Constitutional Court hearing against Jacob Zuma and the Nkandla trial, the Nkandla case and Parliament shows that no institution is higher than our constitution, and no one is higher than our democracy. And I think it's something that we as South Africans really need to value, because as much as yes, things sometimes can look bleak in this country, there's so many things that work and we should be really grateful.
Ukhambile-ke uMandela. Kwanje okuseleko kusezandleni zabakhi beSewula Afrika ukuthi bawusebenzisa njani umthetho sisekelo.
I read a very interesting article recently that said that when the constitution was drafted, there are quite a few appointments that the president gets to make on his own discretion. He doesn't have to seek advice from parliament and so on. And when this was put into legislation, the drafters of the constitution always thought that we'd have a Mandela as a president. So they always thought that these appointments will be made by someone like Mandela.
Izakhamuzi ezifana nabahlali beClipland Hostel KwaZulu-Natal babantu ebebafuna isizo likaThuli Madonsela kodwa lingafiki msinyana. Mningi umsebenzi osalele emva.
She's doing her work. The only problem is that she doesn't have the necessary budget, and as a result she's unable to investigate a lot of cases which gets to be sent to her her office. We need to give her the money. She must go and open offices in the municipalities so that people can just walk in and lay complaints, particularly about the municipalities and the local councillors who think they are royal chiefs in their areas there. Let it benefit ordinary people. They must not see it as if it's some elite arrangement where the public protector is meant to investigate ministers, presidents and high profile politicians.
If the reported corruption that occurred just before 1994 or immediately after in the hands of the apartheid government or in the hands of the remnants of the apartheid government, where some lands were leased to people for 1 rand a year because they were white, where some properties abroad where spies and diplomats were staying were simply given away, if a person could investigate cases of that nature, I'm almost certain it would elevate that person to the same status.
As much as people complain about the state of our politics at this time, there's a lot of good things that have come out in recent times that shows that our democracy is actually very functional. You know, our constitution is one of the best constitutions in the world. The office of the public protector under Thuli Madonsela shows how this office that came out of the constitution that supports constitutional democracy can really thrive in an African country, and it's been working well and it can potentially work even better.
Sekufana nokuthi kunokudluliselana ngendonga yobukhosi phakathi kwabavikeli bomphakathi ababili laba. Kuzoba nemphumela ngeoffice le public protector. Nongaba nesiqundo ngekusasa leSouth Africa yonke. Okay.